Welcome to the latest episode of Branding the Experience. We discuss ways we can create environments where employees actually want to come to work and customers want to keep coming back. Hi, I'm Ken Bader, your host for Branding the Experience. Our subject today is image and experience because the two of them go hand in hand. In fact, everything is integrated and needs to be aligned, whether you realize it or not. That's the whole premise of my B plus C plus S formula, brand, culture, and strategy alignment. But I want to talk particularly about the connection between image and experience, because it's all in our tagline for this show, is that you can't have one without the other. In fact, when I talk about brand, culture, and strategy, the three questions that I say that B plus C plus S formula answers are: one, what is the image you want your business to portray to the public? Two, what experience do you need to create both for and through your employees? And last, how do we drive more of the right business to our business? That's more of the strategy part. But in talking about the brand and culture, the image and the experience, we can't have one without the other. If we have built a great image from a branding and marketing standpoint, but the experience doesn't match what we've promised, well, then we don't get repeat customers because they basically feel like they've been lied to. And the other works as well. If we create this great experience for our employees that then transfers over to a great experience for our customers, clients, or members, but we haven't really branded it properly, then we're going to have a real problem in driving the right people to that experience. We're going to be basically rolling the dice or God forbid, praying and hoping that somebody actually comes through our door. So we need to make sure that when we're thinking of branding, especially from a marketing messaging standpoint and the tactics that we use, we're also thinking about the experience that we're providing. Now, if we're providing an awesome experience already and the employees are happy to be there, and when a customer comes into your place of business, they are extremely happy with what they're experiencing, then great. Let's talk about that particular brand experience in our marketing. And we actually, in many respects, have a leg up on a number of different businesses, especially our competitors. But if our experience is, frankly, lackluster, if we find on Yelp that we're getting two and a half stars consistently, and I get it, not everybody's happy. If you get one-star review and everything else is four or five, then certainly respond to that one star. But we don't have to be too concerned. Sometimes we have an off day. And sometimes, frankly, we just have a customer that has just unreasonable expectations. But, if one or two stars is the norm, then you got a major problem. And before you even think about branding and marketing communications, you need to improve that experience. And many times, maybe that doesn't necessarily start on the external of how we serve people at the bank or we serve people at the restaurant. Maybe it starts internally. Because if our employees are constantly coming in with an attitude, if it's one, maybe we just need to, allow that person to be made available for other employment. But if we have 10 employees and 9 of them come in with a bug up their rectum, as I like to say, maybe we are the problem as an owner or manager, and we need to create a better experience, a better environment for that employee base so that they can transfer a positive attitude to the customers in the form of a positive experience. And then from an image standpoint, we really do have something to promote from a brand messaging and marketing angle, because when we market it and we drive people to the experience, it's a promise that's kept. It's a promise of, hey, we're a family-oriented restaurant, and when you come, you actually get a family-oriented experience. Or we're a credit union specifically for teachers, and we brand that And when somebody walks through our door or calls on the phone or even transacts with us via our website or our online programs, they feel that there's a true affinity for educators at that particular institution, more so than somebody that or some business or bank that will deal with just anybody off the street. So think about the connection of the image and the experience, and make sure both are branded at a very high level, because that's what it takes to brand the experience at your unique business. Thanks for spending some time with me today. Take care.